when you come out from your sentence of IPP, you are on license for the rest of your life. You may, with a fair wind, after 10 years, ask to be relieved of the consequences of that life license. But for those who got short-term sentences, to be on license for life, or even for 10 years, no one will come out before 2015 at the very earliest. I just invite you to say, whether or not you agree with me, that that is a further injustice which needs to be addressed.
I've already made my view clear. My preferred option is extended sentences, which would have that exact penalty.
I thought that in fact that the existence of the system was a license for only 10 years, not for life. But if it is for life, I quite agree with what you said. As part of the deal, the license should be reduced, possibly expire the other.
Very, very briefly, one of the IPC sentences that was passed was a tariff of 28 days. A tariff of 28 days and a life license.
I've just seen what we're talking about is you can't stop people on what they need in a system about what they have done. That's actually what Ken put said very clearly. And he wants to think it's within this group of people who will be sitting down with Ken.
I'm Brian Barker, and my blog has become a sort of clearinghouse for information and advice for families of IPPs for several years. I have two questions really for Mr. Weatherby, which are an amateur layman's suggestions for arguments that might be put to the European Court or to the British courts under the Human Rights Act. First of all, it seems to me that since even the Ministry of Justice describes the tariffs as the punishment part of an IPP sentence, those prisoners who are past their tariffs are no longer being punished. They're being held in preventive detention. Preventive detention, I would argue, has no place in a civilized society at all. It's totally discredited in Ireland, and it's not recognized generally as being what it is. Sorry. Preventive detention.
Question is?
Oh, sorry, the question is this a legitimate argument that could be put to the European Court? Second question relates to the question of licensing. Is it legitimate to hold people for the rest of their lives under license without any possibility of judicial review or appeal to the courts?
Quick answer to that without prison. Very briefly, the course of human rights has spoken. There is nothing unlawful about preventative detention unless it's not accompanied in the current circumstances by